In this video, we'll take a deep dive into the Vickers Hardness Testing of a steel cube. From setting up the sample to analyzing the results, you'll be amazed by the power and simplicity of Vickers testing. Whether you're a material science enthusiast or just looking to expand your knowledge, you've come to the right video. Stick with me until the end of the video to learn more about two important defects that can occur in different kinds of steel when you're doing Vickers hardness testing. The reference standard for this test method is ASTM E92. There are other equivalent test methods like ISO 9015-1, ISO 6507-1, IS 1501-1, and ASTM E384. For thin and soft materials, a dedicated micro Vickers hardness testing is available, which we can look at a later video. A quick refresher. Hardness is nothing but the resistance to indentation, and that's all you need to know. The Vickers hardness is a hardness reading which is based on a specific type of indenter, which we shall look at in the upcoming sections. This test method is applicable to metals, and it uses a test force between 1 gram force to 120 kilogram force. This is the force applied to the sample via the indenter. We'll also examine the process of selecting the right test force for the metal. For accurate test results, the hardness reading has to be taken on a flat specimen with a polished surface. Since this specimen was cut from a plate, the surface could still have ridges and grooves at a microscopic level that can impact the hardness readings. This sample does not require any mounting. However, let me know in the comments below if you'd like to see a dedicated video that requires a mounted specimen. Unless you're a materials expert, there's no way to find out if your test is valid until after you finish your testing and measuring the dyno length. The depth of indentation is at least 1/7 the mean dyno length. Hardness can be correlated with the tensile strength, but only to a certain extent. If you haven't watched a tensile testing video already, be sure to click the link above. The indenter is a square-based pyramidal diamond with face angles of 136 degrees. The preparation follows ASTM E3, where fine polishing is carried out with a diamond paste. This will make it easier to measure the indentation under the camera. An oxide slurry can also be used for softer steels and non-ferrous materials. The sample is carefully cleaned between stages to prevent contamination. Ensure that there is no excessive heating or cold working during the preparation. This sample does not require any mounting. The diamond indenter is brought into contact perpendicular to the sample, and the force F is applied. The time from the initial application of force to the full test force should not be more than 10 seconds. The full test force shall be applied for 10 to 15 seconds. Other non-standard test times can be applied for some materials. The test equipment has a camera through which the indentation is seen. The lengths of the two diagonals of the indentations are measured and the mean diagonal length is calculated. From here, the Vickers hardness is calculated using the formula shown here. Thanks to technology, this is automatically calculated for me. The hardness value is reported as a number followed by the symbol HV that denotes the scale as Vickers hardness. This is followed by the test load in kgf, which is 10 kilogram force in our case. If a non-standard dwell time is used, this is denoted in seconds at the end of the sequence, starting with a slash character. The length of the diagonals are to be measured to be within 0.5 micron. For indentations less than 20 micron, the length of diagonals should be determined to within 0.1 micron or less. For micro indentations, having indentation depths in the range of a few microns, the velocity should be between 15 micron per second to 70 micron per second. For macro hardness testing, the contact velocity should be within 0.2 mm per second. The minimum distance from the corner of the sample should be 2.5 times the diagonal length. The spacing between each indentation should also be at least 2.5 times the diagonal length. Check the validity of your results with the help of a hardness reference block that has a pre-certified value. Here is a common question. Does the Vickers hardness change with test loads? No. For homogeneous materials, the Vickers hardness does not change, except for very low forces where the diagonals are smaller than 25 micron. If the corners of the specimen are not in focus, check if the sample is perfectly flat. The thickness of the sample should be at least 10 times the depth of indentation, and we have got that covered. And now, for the bonus section, let's look at two types of defects that happen in metals. The first is the pincushion effect. The edges of the indentation have a concave shape, shown by the red lines, leading to an overestimation of diagonal length. This commonly occurs in annealed materials. Contrary to this effect is the barreled structure. This occurs in work-hardened materials, leading to a convex edge. The diagonal lengths are underestimated in this case. If you got any value out of the video, be sure to subscribe to the channel and get your free worksheet on Vickers hardness testing that's given in the description below.